Hi, this is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Thank you for taking the time to look at these videos and trying to learn the trailer before you come in to look at it. That way you know what kind of questions to ask the salesperson when you're working with them. But in this case, I'm standing in front of a brand new hideout built right here in Pendleton, Oregon by Keystone RV. It's a 27 RV non-slide unit. There's not very many non-slide trailers manufactured today. But it's nice to be able to have one if you don't like the slide. If you want to get into a narrower spot where you don't need more area to put out the slide, this will be a terrific unit. It's got a lot of amenities to it, and I'm going to go ahead and touch base on a few of those during this video. As you notice the hideout, first thing you notice is they've just changed the colors of the paint on the outside. It looks a lot more, instead of a sterile color of white and tan, now it's kind of a tan colored paint with black decals. They look very sharp. You're going to like the looks of it when you come out and look at it. Up front here, they've changed the covers over the top of the propane tank. So instead of using, again, the white sterile single piece propane cover, they actually went to a three-piece black plastic, and it just looks a lot nicer and trimmed out. As we come to this side over here, you got your pass-through storage that they actually increased the height of the storage door a bit, so you can actually put more stuff in the storage area. And it is pass-through, so you can put longer stuff up to 8 foot all the way across this area. So that's great for bass rods, which I like, and or any other type of fishing rods or whatever you may have this long. Skis is another one. Great place to store skis or probably a surfboard or whatever it might be. I have lots of windows in this unit. Also has a utility shower right here. And a sewer clean out area. So this is nice because when you're all done dumping your tanks, you can pop this little cap off, hook your hose up to this, run it for about 3 minutes, and it'll clean out your black tank. So it's going to clean out all the solid debris in there and wash it down through the hose. Also has a water, city water connection right here as well. And then all of your wastewater poles and gray water poles are right here. Also has jacks on all four corners, so it'll stabilize this unit once you get in your campsite. And it has a satellite prep connection right there. Also comes with a spare tire and a carrier. And the water heater is a 6 gallon gas electric hot water heater with DSI. DSI means direct switch ignition. And what that does is as soon as you hit the switch inside, when it turns red, that propane is fired up in there and it's going to start heating water immediately. It also has a switch to turn the electrical part of it on too, so you can heat propane with electricity at 16.2 gallons per hour, or you can just do propane at 7.2 gallons per hour. So anyway, it's your choice. You can save a little bit of money by not burning your propane, just using electricity if you're plugged in, or if you need a lot of hot water to keep everybody washed, well then you want to run them both. As we come around to this side here, it has a nice little storage area right here because this is a bunkhouse. And this is the rear bed right here. This you can lift up and you can put a set of bicycles in here because there's enough room. It opens up from the very back all the way up about 6 feet into the trailer. Here's your electric awning. It is electric and it's operated from inside of the trailer. Here it's got some TV connections right here for your cable and your power. So you can bring the TV from the inside out here and hook it up and be able to see what you're watching outside. Also has exterior speakers so you can listen to your music or TV outside here. Let's go look at the inside. As we come into the living room area, the first thing you run into is a nice big sofa right here that turns into a bed. This is what they call a jackknife sofa. And this pulls out and you can sleep a person here or just sit a person there if you want to watch TV or relax for the day. Has a nice little flip-up countertop right here. Also comes with a dinette with a big table right here as well. It has lots of plastic laying all around that I get to pick up and throw away because somebody left it in here. Comes with a DVD player and a CD player right here, with a USB port and an auxiliary in for an iPod connection. Has a nice storage compartment right here for clothing or canned goods or whatever it may be. And a TV connects right up here. Now this one doesn't come with a TV, but you know, if you come in and you like this unit, let's see what we can do to help you with a TV set. Also has a nice big bathroom area. You're not going to be cramped in this bathroom because they've taken the sink out of the bathroom and put it in the hallway. So you can actually get two people prepping themselves in the morning. So somebody could be brushing their teeth here, somebody else could be taking a shower. Also has a twin bed above here and of course a full bed right here. So you have sleeping for three children back here pretty easily. Has a nice big fridge. Again, this is what they call the helium fridge by Atwood. It's actually a 7 cubic foot fridge instead of a 6. All of your other refrigerators in this class are going to be 6 cubic foot, but this is a 7. And the this has got a helium equipped with tilt sensor technology. What that means is this is going to operate when it's sitting at a slope, where all of your other brands are going to start failing when they start getting at a slope. So this is a better fridge that will work for you in rougher terrain. Also have a stainless steel appliances here. You've got the stove, the oven, and the microwave are all stainless steel appliances. And you're going to notice when you come in and look at this, it's got some very nice colors to it. The cabinets are a deep, rich, kind of a hickory look. And it has night pull-down shades. So they're not the old steel shades that just... the aluminum shade you pull down, these are actually night shades, so it's a better shade. 60-40 sink, lots of storage. If you look in the bedroom area, it's a complete walk-around queen bed. And what I like about this bedroom is it actually has its own solid core door that will shut and give you that person or couple privacy from the rest of the trailer. So if you do have children sleeping with you in the trailer, you're going to get a lot more privacy in this unit than many other because of the door that closes. That's a nice feature. Anyway, if you like unit and you don't like slides, this would be the unit to come look at. Because it doesn't have a slide, it's a lot less expensive and is still built very well, built here in Oregon, has the insulation package it needs to survive in Oregon to keep you warm. Come see Joe Bass at the RV Corral. I'd love to work with you. You know, if you come and ask for Joe Bass and you buy something for me, I'll make sure you get a free gift. Thank you.